Text, University of Michigan. Scenes of University of Michigan campus. Students walking between buildings. A young man enters the College of Pharmacy building. Corey Lester, PhD, PharmD, Assistant Professor of Clinical Pharmacy.
My proposal to the National Library of Medicine was to develop and design artificial intelligence, specifically a computer vision model, which could look at a picture of pills inside a medication bottle and accurately identify the contents of that bottle.
Lester sits with another man, pointing to a computer screen, showing pill data and photos of pills in a pill bottle.
We are testing how that model can be used in collaboration with the human so that errors don't happen in the pharmacy.
Close up person's hand, using pill counting tray.
How do you teach a machine? If you want a machine to differentiate between an anomaly in medical dispensing or not, what do you do is you give the machine images of anomalies, you give the machine images of good medications, and you tell them, this is good, this is bad.
Raed Al Kontar, PhD, Assistant Professor, Industrial Operations Engineering. Photos of pills and pill bottles. Text, how to teach machines. Images of pills and pill bottles, differentiated by color tints and labeled as bad or good. White text, bad, appears over red-tinted pills. White text, good, appears over green-tinted pills. Text, algorithm makes link. Text, can predict medication.
When the algorithm can make this link, then if you give the algorithm a new image, the algorithm can predict. This image belongs to which class? Is it the good group or the bad group? So fundamentally, it's a matching decision done in a fancy mathematical way.
So the way we see this being implemented is once we have that picture of pills in the bottle, we can use this model to predict what medication is in that image and cross-reference it with the expected or intended medication that was supposed to be filled. In this way, we can support pharmacists in their double-check verification of the patient getting the right pill in the right bottle.
The results were surprisingly positive, and we found that our algorithm can predict with an accuracy above 99.5%.
Text, algorithm predicts over 99.5% accurate, appears next to woman handling medication and looking at a computer screen.
But what one thing that we are afraid of, even those 0.5% of errors can be critical. Our hope is that in those cases where the algorithm is wrong, the algorithm can tell us that it is not confident in its results. And then at least the human can double check.
Xi Jessie Yang, PhD, Associate Professor, Industrial Operations Engineering.
Our next step is to conduct the experiment with pharmacists, and through that, we are going to track how their trust change over time on a trial-to-trial basis. So through the experiment, we can collect participants' responses, their physiological signals, and we want to use eye tracking, and by analyzing their responses and signals, we can track how their trust changes over time, how their behaviors, their performance changes over time.
The ultimate goal of this project is to develop safer systems that can be used to save lives and prevent medication errors from causing harm to patients.
It means tons to me. As an engineer, I believe our ultimate mission is to propose solutions that can be used to enhance people's life. Being part of the project is doing just that.
The National Library of Medicine's financial support of this project has really been invaluable. So really, they've been instrumental in making all of this research possible.
Without it, we would not have had the capability to collect all this data, to do all this analysis, and generate the promising results we have right now.
The gray and blue NLM logo, fade up over a white background with blue text, serving scientists and society.